speaker's wife, the wife of the speaker, I beg your pardon, Mrs. Adora, the only man in the house, Honorable Elizabeth Katibian, my honorable colleagues, senior and junior colleagues, honorable commissioners, our woman leader, APC woman leader, Dr. Amalia Sun, and all the women in the house, I welcome you all to today's event. May I also say with special pride and joy to commend the First Lady, Madam Yara Oshomole, who is so lucky to be represented by her husband. And this is Odubo. You know, they say when two people come together, they have become one. So as she's not here today, we are taking it out with saying her name, her husband, our excellency. So, ladies and I'm sure we have some gentlemen here as well. I would like to talk about our lamentations and our excuses as women. First, today I saw women agitating to our deputy governor. I saw women also agitating for a governor, for the next governor of the state. And I marveled. Oh, Madam Jo, I'm sorry. I acknowledge you. I marveled. Because I told myself, I said, oh, the time has come when women are not only struggling to be women leaders in political parties. The time has come when they're not fighting each other to be in the House of Assembly, House of Reps, or other similar positions. I'm sure when Madam Atibian sits in the House of Assembly and sees herself as the only woman or only man in the House, I'm sure she feels some pain in her heart that she alone shares this victory. Now, those are the excuses that we need to talk about. What has brought us to this point where in everything we ask for, we just have a token one person representing us? Also, we think about positions of high authority. There's always one token woman. Coming close to home. I always like to think that it is not only about fighting for the girl child. We have to rise above that box that men put us in, calling us feminists when we fight for the girl child. How about fighting for every child? The boy child is abused as well. The child that walks on the street and is a male is abused. The child that is beaten. When I watched the film that Dr. Joe Odumaki showed us, I was horrified that things like that were being done to girls. We know they're happening, but we've never really seen them vividly. Seeing that vividly brought tears to my eyes. But I also know that boys, the boy child, is going through this kind of treatment as well. Probably worse. So women have to rise above that box that says you only fight for your own gender. If men can think they are big enough to sit atop economies, sit atop social structures and decide for us. Women also have to put themselves on that scale of saying, I can fight not only for my own, but for everybody. Now, going back to the lamentations, Mr. Governor always likes to say, I don't like to hear lamentations, I like to know solutions.